गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू लेसन 6 डिसीजन कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर पेज नंबर 78. सो टुडे वी विल सी हियर स्विच स्टेटमेंट. अर्लियर इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट लाइक इफ स्टेटमेंट, इफ एल्स, एल्स इफ, इफ लैडर, अबाउट दिस कंडीशन कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर्स वी हैव सीन दैट लास्ट क्लास. So here we will continue with this chapter and we will study switch statement. So what is switch statement? The switch statement is used when there is a requirement to check multiple conditions in a program. So whenever we will use this switch statement, as I told that when we have started this chapter, so it was divided, means this condition control structure were divided into three categories. First of all, selection control structure. Second was looping control structure. Then jumping control structure. So when we see this one, Java supports actually in the selection control structure. In the selection control structure, Java suppose in this selection control structure, Java supports there are two types of selection Java supports. First one it was if, okay, and second was switch, okay. Second it was switch. So about this if already we have discussed, there are three categories like if statement, if else statement, if else if ladder statement. Three are there. Now today we will study switch statement, okay. So what is the switch statement? In this switch statement we will see that it is check multiple conditions in a program. What does it? It checks the multiple conditions in a program. It provides an easy way to branch to different parts of the code in a program based on the value of expression. Okay, so different parts of program it will check based on the condition. It is a substitute of large series of if else. Means suppose many times if else we will use, like in the last class I have given the like example, like if you will get the ticket, if you will get the ticket, so where you will go? We will watch the movie. If you will not get the ticket, we will go to the restaurant, okay. We will go to the restaurant and eat. If it is a close, we will go to the park. Okay, suppose more these are the conditions we have given, like was the movie, restaurant, park. So to read of this so many times, if I add the some more conditions, if park is also closed, so we will go to the somewhere, okay, we will go for the marketing. If again that mall is closed, so we will go to the swimming or something. Means likewise we are giving the condition. So how many times we will use if else, so many times we will use that. So to rid of that means to overcome come on that means we will to save our time to by using again and again if else statement. So there we can, this control structure has switch statement which store an expression. It has also multiple cases where each case has unique label. That case has a unique label means that will be the numbered, that will be numbered with a unique one, that will be the uniquely defined. And that I will tell you about what is the unique label. A block of statement associated with it. The value of switch expression is compared to the labels of the case. So that switch expression will be compared with the label. So that's why I told that this label will be the unique one. So how to define that we will see. If expression matches, the statement associated with the case get executed. If none of case match, the compiler execute the statement retain the default case. Same like that, if else that will be checked. If nothing is there means no condition is matched, so automatically it will go to the default case. Any default case means the last case, it will go to the last case. Like here in this example you can see, this is also not true, so one is the default, one will be there, so nothing will be there, so what these things we I will do, so that that is the default case, okay. So see, the first of all is the syntax switch, we will use, this is the keyword, like if is the keyword, okay, so similarly there the switch is the keyword, okay, that is used in the Java. This is a reserved word that we cannot use for the declaration purpose, okay, that is the keyword switch. In the switch we will inside the switch we will put the some condition. So there is the condition, that is the expression. Now first one, now it is there the expression. Now here it will start, okay. Here the expression means the value. Expression means the value means what you have to do. Means like there are 5-6 conditions, okay. So in that value we will write, means like that value means what is exactly true. So that value we will write. So we will you will more understand when we will see the program. So first you just understand, then we write the expression. So what we have to do, that we will write there. Now case 1 label 1. So here is that this block statement executed the value switch expression matches the label 1. So what you have to take care, you have to take care about this label 1. This name should be unique. This label, it is written here, it should be the unique one, okay. This uniqueness means that should not match with this, means this value whatever the here is entered, like we will enter the movie, so that name should be there like movie. Here is the name like that is go to the park, so it should be written there park, so that exactly the condition will match. So here is that condition is that we have to go to the movie, so it is telling that movie, so it directly it will come. Likewise name you can just say, like here we have written the student's name, so like there's Mohan, Shyam, Sita, Gita, so any name will be there, it will simply call, or simple to like that you can understand. This is your class, okay, you all are sitting at different positions, okay, and suppose I call the name, suppose the name is A, B, C, D, E and F, so all this, just try to understand, these all come under the switch cases. These are all are the cases of the switch, and I just hear the switch. Switch means here is the name of this is the student. If this is the, it is comes the order like from the principal office, it is called the A. Simply it will come to the A and it will call. Okay, simple, if it is come the calling B, come to the B and find out. Suppose F, so simply here is the, where is the F, it will call to the F. No need to check others rest because we know the information who is the F. Simple, we will go to the F and we will call. Nothing is there, so by default not go to the anywhere, that is the default case. Switch means directly that will go and call that particular person, and because that has the unique name, that is because in your class like you all students have different names, unique name, so by that name we can call out you. Similarly here it will work, okay. So likewise, and there is after that you can see this is the break. Break means if this program will execute, then this program will execute, then after it will stop breaking. If you will not use this break, it will come to the here. So that's it means that if the work is over, stop. Again this is the stop, and there is the, it is the default means the last one. No, if nobody is here, no any statement is true, simply you come to the default, and then after break means that the block's work is over. So here as you can see, this block of statement get executed if the value of switch expression does not match with any case, means all the statements are false, okay. Now next, the break statement, what is the use of this break? Break statement takes the flow of control out of the switch, as I told that, means it will be taken, it will take out from the switch statement. Without break statement, execution would simply continue to the next step. As I told that, if you will not use this break here, here is that, in this case, if you will not use the break here, what it will happen? So it will come to the here, then after it will come to there, one by one, all the conditions it will check. Break means simply, okay, get out from there. So that's the use of break. The value stored in expression should be type int or character. So value is that is should be int or character, and value defined in each case. As I told that, here is the expression, this should be integer or character. Here is this switch case expression, here whatever you will declare, that must be what it should be. It should be integer or character, and value defined in each case should be matching the value stored in the expression. Whatever the value, as I told that, whatever the value you are storing in this expression, that will match with this label. Suppose you have stored there 1 to 5, 1 to 9, all the digits. So here will be the like 1, 2, 3, 4, anything. You cannot write A, B or C. Okay, so it should not be like this. It should be 1, 2, 3 because it should have to match with the expression. Okay, each case value should be unique literals. Okay, as I told that it should be unique because like your name in your like in any class, the student having this name, because that so its uniqueness as well as roll number, that is also unique. So it something that should be unique that we can identify. So that case name, that level 1, level 2, whatever is written, that should be unique. This one, this should be the unique one. This should be, this portion should be unique. Okay. Now, and it should be a constant, not a variable. And whatever the name you are writing, that should be constant. Always you are just taking your, keep in your mind, it should be the constant. What it should be? It should be constant, not a variable. The default is the last statement of switch case. It is an optional statement, but default is in that one. This is the optional statement. It executes only when the value stored in switch expression does not match any case. Okay, like every like earlier, whatever the steps we have come, if all are false, then it will execute. That is the default one. Okay, let's see the program. Write a program to accept number from the user and print according print the corresponding color of RGB. Example, if 1, then write red, 2 for green, 3 for blue. So how to write? Simple. First of all, we declare the class. Class name is the RGB. Then after we have declared this one main function, and through here we have passed the value. Okay, integer type value. Value is declared here. So when value is declared, it will ask to you enter the value. So whatever the value means, you will enter, suppose 2, 3, 1, whatever you have entered. So you can enter that value will come to now under this switch statement. Suppose you have entered the 1. So this value is now 1. Switch condition is the value is this value is actually what expression in the last we have seen here. Here is this is expression. Okay, so this expression now it's a value going to 1. So now it means this 1 means it will check where the case label. It will check to the where is the 1. Here is the 1, it will come to the 1. If we have entered here 2, suppose we have entered 2. So it will, this switch will not send here. It will not send here. Where it will send? Where its value is 2. This case value is where is 2? Here. It will come to here. Suppose we have entered 3. So it will not come to this statement. This case value will not check. Even case 2 will not check 3, because this 3 is exactly matching with the expression and the case label. That must be matched. It will come to here. Suppose we have entered 5. So no any condition, simply it will come to the default and it will execute here. Nothing will be checked here. So that's the working process. So here you can see once again. So this is the value. Now case 1, if it is true, then it will display color is red and bracket. If condition 2 is true, it will be displayed inside the 2. Then 3, if nobody is true, so here is wrong choice and everything is closed. Got it? Now here is see some facts. The order in which statement are executed in running program is called flow of control. That is, in order it is running, one by one it is coming. So this is called the flow of control. The order in which statement are executed. In order in which statements are executed in a running program is called flow of control. Okay. Now next we have looping control structure. So next part we will see here now, which is the looping control structure. As I when we started, so we know that computer means the in this Java condition control, there in the this how many categories it was divided. That was selection. It was divided into the selection control. It was divided into selection. Then it was divided into looping, and last one it is divided into jumping control. So about selection we have studied, like if statement and switch. Okay, now we will see the looping. The second part we will see the looping. So in this looping, control structure we will see the a loop is a sequence of instruction that is continuously repeated until a specified condition becomes true. Okay, so loop is a sequence of instruction that is continuously, means continually repeated, continually it will be repeated until the specified condition became true, means it will check till that. When it is not true, it will keep on checking. Means like I told that a equals to 5, first I told 1 2 3, means 1 2 3 4, all it will be checked. Okay, now let us understand with the help of some example. Suppose your instructor order you run and take 10 round of a ground to warm up. Okay, the very first thing that you need to do this, a fixed starting point, means you have to run on this here. So first of all, you have to fix the starting point anywhere on this. Then after, on reaching the starting point, again means from here to here you have to reach, because that's you have to do, you complete one round. Means if you will fix this one, then you will know from here we started and completed one round. So because I have to take the 10 round, so how we will decide? First of all, we have to fix the starting point. Then you can take the second round and so on. This way you keep track the number of rounds until the process is completed. The process which goes in your mind is that you set the value control variable in your mind and keep increment in the until the value is reach the limit. Means this point you have fixed, this is my starting point. Once you come, okay, you in your mind one, again you will come, okay, you just counted one, means you have now this value is 2. Again you have come from here, so 1 plus means 3, means that in your mind it is continuously, it is increasing the value one by one. Okay, because you have to count for the 10. Okay, so in this way looping will also work. Okay, so before so one fact is here, the break statement is usually used at the end of each case alternative of switch statement. Okay, so that's about the break. Now there is some example. Let us say control variable is C, which is start a phrase from the starting number. The number is usually 0 or 1. When you complete the first round, the value became 1. After the second round, value becomes C plus 1, means 2. As I told that first round, you first generally 0 or 1 we are keeping. 0 simply means that is initially 0 because we have started one round completed, means 1. Means 0 plus 1. Then after one round again completed, means 1 plus 1, because 0 plus 1 is 1, then after 1. So likewise we are repeatedly we are increasing it. Okay, so in this way this looping control structure is working. So here is you see, sometimes you may to repeat a particular task many times. At that time, repeating the corresponding statement would be a bad programming practice. To avoid repetition of same instruction, looping control structure are used. Means like same statement you are using again and again. So that's a bad impression, because it is told that in the programming, means your program should be quite concise and your repetition of coding should not be there. Means like same coding you are using again and again, means you are not that is not a good impression for the programmer. Means always we should avoid the repetition of the program, because it makes lengthy your program. So always we try to write the short programs, and we have to always read of that. We should not write the repetitions of the statements. So in this case, looping is the best way. A simple looping control structure has a condition and block of statements. Till time the specified condition remains true, the compiler keeps executing the loop and the subsequent statements are written inside its body. The code repeated in such a manner is called iteration. Iteration means nothing but it is a iteration means repetition. One means that will check, keep on checking. Okay, like 1 to 8 means all the students 1 to 8 it will check. Means keep on iteration one by one means till that will be not true, it will check. That is the iteration. Okay, repetition, that will means like repeatedly it will check. A loop control structure contains the following part. There are some parts, so before that here is some fact. If break statement is not applied at the end of each case, then the control enters the next statement for the execution. As you know that if you will not use the break, it will go to the next. दिस अनयूजुअल एजुकेशन ऑफ मोर देन वन केस ऑफ टाइम इज टर्म एज फॉल. इफ यू विल नॉट यूज द ब्रेक मीन्स इट विल गो टू द अनदर केस देन आफ्टर गो टू द अनदर केस इट मीन्स दैट इट दैट केस इज कॉल्ड फॉल थ्रू दैट इज कॉल्ड द फॉल थ्रू मीन्स बिकॉज यूजलेसली वी आर वेस्टिंग द टाइम एंड वी आर चेकिंग द यूजलेस स्टेटमेंट बिकॉज दैट इज नॉट ट्रू सो दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड द फॉल थ्रू इन विच द एजुकेशन ऑफ प्रोग्राम स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द करेक्ट केस बट डज नॉट स्टॉप टिल फाइंड द ब्रेक स्टेटमेंट ओके एंड और स्विच टर्मिनेट्स सो दैट्स द फॉल ऑफ टाइम एंड वेस्ट ऑफ द टाइम ऑल्सो सो नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हियर वी विल सी नाउ हियर इन दिस केस लूपिंग कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर फर्स्ट इज दैट कंट्रोल वेरिएबल फर्स्ट वन इज वी हैव कंट्रोल वेरिएबल इट इज़ अ वेरिएबल विच कंटेन्स इनिशियल वैल्यू टू डिटरमाइन द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ रिपीटेशन सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन द इनिशियल वैल्यू फ्रॉम वेयर वी विल राउंड सो वन एग्जाम्पल वी हैव टेकन सपोज वी हैव टू टेक द राउंड ऑफ दिस ग्राउंड तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू फिक्स द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट सो समवेयर वी शुड हैव द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द दिस इज द कंट्रोल वेरिएबल सो मीन्स वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन द इनिशियल वैल्यू ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट बॉडी ऑफ द लूप सो इट इज सेट ऑफ स्टेटमेंट विच आर एजुकेटेड विद इन द लूप सेमिटेसली मीन्स दैट इज द बॉडी ऑफ द लूप मीन्स दैट विल बी लाइक इन योर माइंड इट विल कैलकुलेट लाइक वन राउंड टू राउंड सो दैट्स फंक्शनेटिंग सो दैट्स द बॉडी ऑफ द लूप इट इज ए सेट ऑफ स्टेटमेंट्स विच आर एजुकेटेड विद इन द लूप सेमिटेसली नेक्स्ट वन टेस्ट कंडीशन एवरी लूप कंटेन्स टेस्ट कंडीशन विच टेक वेदर लूप हैज़ टू बी रिपीटेड और टर्मिनेटेड मीन्स लाइक दिस इज द बॉडी मीन्स यू आर स्टार्टेड रनिंग सो इन योर माइंड वी हैव योर ऑर्डर इज दैट यू हैव टू टेक द 10 राउंड सो फर्स्ट राउंड यू हैव कंप्लीटेड देन आफ्टर टू सेकेंड सो इट इज कीप ऑन इंक्रीजिंग एंड ऑल्सो यू आर चेकिंग दैट वेदर इट इज कंप्लीटेड और नॉट मीन्स इफ इट इज लेस देन 10 आई हैव टू टेक मोर इफ इट इज लेस देन 10 आई हैव टू टेक वन मोर मीन्स टिल दैट इट इज नॉट मोर देन 10 वी हैव टू कीप ऑन गोइंग मीन्स कीप ऑन रनिंग वी हैव टू रन इट so in that so that is called the test condition so every loop condition it takes a test condition which check whether the loop has to repeated or terminated depending on the condition control enters into the body of the loop and executes till the condition becomes false okay next step value it determines the increment and decrement of control variable unless test condition became false ओके सो इट विल कीप ऑन चेकिंग टिल वी आर नॉट बी फॉल्स मीन्स इट इज नॉट फिनिश फॉल्स मीन्स 10 राउंड वी हैव टू फिनिश सो वी विल चेक दैट ग्रेटर देन मीन्स इन माइंड वन बाय वन वी आर इंक्रीजिंग वेन इट इज अबाउट टू मोर देन 10 सो दैट इज देयर वी हैव टू स्टॉप मीन्स द कंडीशन विल बी फॉल्स सो हियर इज दैट द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस looping structure first one is your for loop there are some part so based on the nature of iteration java provides basic looping structure so earlier like in that if else if ladder so there are three part for that now here is we have again three part for the looping structure first one for loop second while loop and third one do while loop okay so one by one we will discuss first of all for loop For loop is used to repeat a particular task for finite number of times. Means the number is fixed, means for the particular number of time we have to repeat it. It performs a fixed number of iteration which are specified in a counter variable, which turns keep a track of the number of iterations. Means we will specify some numbers. Means till that it will be work. So see the syntax and you will understand. First of all, for initialize expression. So for this is you have to write the for and inside this bracket you have to first write the expression condition and it's a increment. So there are three parts. First of all, it's a starting means as I told that. First of all, when you are started when you start the running. So first of all, what you are doing? First of all, you fix the initial point. So that's the initial point. Then after condition expression condition we are giving means 10 condition how many round first we fix this from where we have to start running so that point we have fixed Now, how many times we will run? So that condition we will give here. So that's the condition. And the third part, which is the increment. So how it will work? Means its condition is given, and now what is working here? So that will increase by 1 plus 1 plus 1. So that means we have started running. So in our mind that will calculate. So that will be worked here. Okay. So now, and it will be, there is the, this is the part of this for loop. It will true if it, this statement is true, it will go here. It true, come to here, means this work, this is block of statements will work. If it is not true, it will execute. So it's a, you can see it's a flow chart. Like it will start from the start, initialize, it will start, then after is a decision box text. If it is a true, then it will come here and it will increment, means one first true, it will come here and its value will be increment by 1, means first round completed. So it will write like first round completed and 1 plus, so that is the increment, so come to here. Again second round completed plus 1 increment, third round plus 1. So likewise it will keep on going till that we are not exceed the 10. So when we will exceed the 10, more than 10, so that in that case it will come false and it will be stopped. Okay, so this is the working of the for loop. So about some for loop, you can see here, for loop works with the following way. So there are some methods, how does it work? So that first of all you see it here. So the initialization of expression is initialized only once at the beginning of for loop. So it's a rule this, that whenever you are using the for loop, you have to declare at the top, means earlier once you have to begin it. Okay, you have to initialize it. The step allows you to declare and initialize any loop control variable. You cannot require to put a statement there as long as semicolon appears. Okay, means only you have to give the, what you have to give, you have to only initialize it, you have to give the condition. Then after next text expressions is evaluated, if condition is true, then the body of loop will be executed. If it is true, then it will be work. If it is false, that will come out from that looping. Next, after the loop body is executed, the control goes increment expression. The summarize the executions happen in the following order, that is like a 1 2 3 4, that will be executed, means that will be increased. At any point of time when conditional expression became false, so loop will get terminated and it will stop. Okay, if it is false, means that expression, means the its value will be the false, so then it will be terminated, that loop will come out. Okay, the control of execution move to the statement following the loop if there is any. Okay, now this for loop is also called entry controlled loop. This is also called entry controlled loop because the body of the loop executed only after the condition evaluates the true. It means, what does it mean? Means if it is a true, means only when it is running, if, because it is called, this for loop is called entry controlled loop because the body of loop is executed only after the condition evaluates true. Because as we know that this for loop will be always on the top, so first of all when it will be true, then it will come to the here. So in another way we can say that first if it is true, then the statement will be executed. If it is a false in the beginning, if it is a false in the beginning, so this it will not executed if the false is in the beginning, so it will be terminated from here. Okay, so now let's see this for looping, some program based on this. So first program is like, write a program to print the first 10 natural number. So what is natural number? That number which began with from 1, whole number is started from 0, but the natural number started from 1. Okay, so I have to print the all the 10 natural number from 1 to 10. So how to do? So first of all we declare a class, that's the name is number. Okay, then after main function, and there is a string argument we have passed. Now here we have declared integer a. Okay, so here we have declared one variable. Then after, this is the important part. Okay, we will use the for loop. So how to use the for loop? First of all we write the for, because this, and this for is the keyword. Start the bracket, देन आफ्टर वट इज द वेरिएबल वी हैव टेकन, ए इज द वन ऑफ द वेरिएबल एंड इट्स अ वैल्यू वी हैव स्टार्टेड वन, मीन्स वट इज द इनिशियल वैल्यू ऑफ ए इज वन एंड यू नो दैट वट इज हेयर यू कैन सी इट्स अ सिंटेक्स हाउ टू राइट दिस फॉर लूप. सो इट इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू इनिशलाइज द एक्सप्रेशन, द सेकेंड कंडीशनल, देन आफ्टर इंक्रीमेंट और डिक्रीमेंट, द सेम हेयर वी विल डू. ओके सो दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल what we will do, we will initialize it. So we have initialized a is equals to 1, then after semicolon. Okay, this is the initialize, we have initialized it. Next part what we will do, we will give the condition, means what condition it should be. So a condition is that a should less than or equals to 10, because we have to go up to the 10, so that's why it should be less than and equal to 10. This is the condition I have given, then semicolon. Then after the next part we have to increment or decrement. I have to increase or decrease. So this a will be increased, so we will write this plus plus. Plus plus means that value will be increased. Okay, so now how it will work, so see it's a working. First of all, a's value here, when it's a come here for this loop, so a's value is 1. So okay, and this is condition. First, here is a's value less, means a's value is 1, means this a greater less than equals to 1. So this is true, sorry, here is 10. So this value is 1 actually. This in now currently a's value is 1. So 1 is less than greater than equals to 10. Yeah, it is correct, because any one condition should be followed, either less than or equal to. So here it is less than. Okay, and this is true, so it means it will execute. So this for loop will come here and system dot print out the value. So here what is the value of a, in this case what is the value of a is currently now 1, so this 1 will be displayed. Now in second case, now it will come out this loop and again it will come here. Okay, again it will come to here because the first is over. Now this, because it is incremented, now first a's value is 1, this condition checked and increment, so all are true. So this for loop will take place, and now currently now this increment, this a's value is now, means earlier it was 1, now 1 plus 1 it's became now a's value is now 2. So next time this loop will come for the 2, a equals to, now here is a equals to, now next value a equals to 2. Okay, this 2 again it will check correct and increment. So then now next, so here it will, the values currently will be, so current value 2, then after it will increment, so it will be now then again 3, so then again it will come here and execute. Likewise it will execute till it is not false. When it will false, when the value of a will be 11, when it will be the 11, so this statement will be false, this condition will be false, then after it will not execute and it will stop there. So that is the use of for loop. You can write this program same in the for like one by one, you can write the function and you can write it like by using that function, first of 1, 2, 3, likewise you can write, but the use of for loop we don't have to repeat it again and again. Okay, now next we have a write program to print odd number between 1 to 10. So all the odd numbers we have to write between. So as I told that if you have the problem is like how to write the program. So first what you can do, you can prefer to write a one of the flow chart. So in that you will understand like this, first we will start initialize with the 1. Then after we will take, because we have to 1 to 10. So all the values should be less than 10 or equals to 10. So that's why this condition mark is there. Okay, a less than equals to 10, because all the numbers between that 1 to 10. So it means it will be below of 10 or equals to 10. So that's why, now if it is true, if this condition is true, then it will execute. Otherwise if value will greater than 10, so that no needed. So it's out, it will be out from this loop. Okay, no need to check anything. So here if it is a true, then after come to the print a, then after if it is a true, then after what we will do here, we will increment by 2, because even number, like we have to write the all the, sorry, here is we have to write the odd number. So suppose the first odd number 1 will come, so next if we will add 2, then 3 will come. So in 3 we will add 2, means likewise we have to write. So that we have to follow. So first of all, we will declare the class name. This is the main function, integer. Now age value started 1, means from 1 we have to start. So age value is 1. So first value will be the, here is the print a, because this is true, this condition also gets true, and it is incremented. Now it is incremented means a plus 2, means 1 plus 2. It is incremented like this, 1 plus 2. So this is 1 plus 2 equals now 3. So second time when it will come, so now here value will be 3. First time it is a. Okay, second time 3. So this 3 will be executed and it will be true. So that 3 will be displayed. Then after again it will increase by 2. In the last program you can see here in the here, it was increased by a plus plus, means 1 step it is increasing, plus 1, plus plus simple plus plus means it will increase by 1, or minus minus it will decrease by 1. But here it is specified clearly a plus 2, means in a you have to add the 2. That's the, okay. Now one more program you can see, write a program to print the square of 10 numbers, sorry, first 10 numbers. So we have to write the square, means like 1 into 1, 1, 2 into 2, 4. Likewise, so you go, for what we have will do, first of all, we declare the class, main function. Here is two variables we have used, that is int I and sq, square. Two variables we have declared, what is I and sq, okay. And also we have given the value, sq's value is 0, means initial value we have given 0. Then after I's value, here we have started with the 1, and it, because we have to print up to the 10, okay. So now less than 10, this this concept we will use, means equals to 10 or less than 10, means up to 10. So this condition we have given, and we have to increase 1 by 1, because all the numbers we have to between 1 to 10 we have to find the square, 1 2 3. So that's why 1 we will increase. Now in this for loop, first of all, this condition will be satisfied. What is the condition? It should be, or equals to, a should be less than equals to 10. If it is satisfied, it will come here. Here what I have to do, square equals to, means in the square I into I, this I star means multiply I into I. So what is the value of I is here? First time 1, so 1 into 1, okay. And earlier we have, this is, we have given 0, means first time it was in the 0 computer, and it's a kept its value 0. But when I will give 1 into 1, okay. So this 1 into 1 give 1, and this 1 will store here in square 1. This value now, square's value is now 1, because this 1 into 1 will store in sq. And so here you can see, so this is the square of I plus I. This is plus I means this is square of 1 1. Okay, the value of I is written here. Okay, I, this is square, the value of I means 1, and its the value gets a square value 2. Okay, you can see here, 1 minute. Yeah, here you can see square I. So it will give the 1. This is the square I. Okay, I's value is 1, and what is the value of sq? 2. Next time when it will come to here, this value will be incremented 1. So now I's value is become now 2. So you can see here is the 2. So now this 2 into 2, here is I into I, 2 into 2, its value is 4. Likewise, it will keep on going, okay, up to the 10th. So in this way, so this programs you can practice, okay. And once you just revise by yourself, you will get it is nicely, okay. You will understand what is the use of this for loop and how to use it, okay.